So good afternoon and welcome to the 2010 Physiology Distinguished Lecture sponsored by the Department of Physiology of the David Geffen School of Medicine. Let me remind you that this initiative emerged from the unanimous perception by the faculty of our department that here at UCLA we should have a high-level lecture series intended to motivate students and young investigators in their research pursuits by exposing them to world pioneers in physiology, be it integrative, cellular, or molecular physiology. We're very, very happy to have our second speaker in this series today, Professor Roger Tsien, the 2008 Nobel Laureate in Chemistry. And he is going to deliver the lecture today. So although Roger told me that I should say, just he's too famous, don't introduce me, I'm not going to do that. I'll talk a little bit about him before, just to embarrass him. So mostly I'm going to focus on the significance of having Roger here as a physiology lecturer. And I must note first that unlike is stated in Wikipedia and in many websites that you'll find, Roger Tsien is not a biochemist, he's a physiologist. Yeah, I know that he's laughing. He received his PhD in physiology from the University of Cambridge, England, in 1977 for work at Churchill College from the University of Cambridge. And he worked in the prestigious physiological laboratory, and that's the reason why he got his degree. Moreover, Roger received later the Getch Prize from the University of Cambridge. And according to the statutes and ordinance of this university, I'm trying to convince him that he's a physiologist, as you can notice, says that the faculty board of biology chooses the Getch Prize among people, and I quote, for their best original observations in physiology or any branch thereof, that is to say, histology, physiological chemistry, or physiological physics, the word physiology being used in the broad sense, end of quote. So in that sense, I must say that this university that is very prestigious, that has formed very many important physiologists in the world, is giving us the leeway at least to say that Robert's Nobel Prize in Chemistry actually may have been because of enormous passion for physiology. So I have to clarify that Roger agrees with this at least, but I can say for sure, now being serious, that Roger's contributions to the modernization of physiological research are simply monumental and they have no parallel. For example, it is likely that the great majority of this audience have already direct experience with the use of optical probes to measure calcium concentration changes in live cells, which were conceptually designed and synthesized by Roger Tsien's laboratory as a sequel of his doctoral work in which he designed and synthesized the improved calcium buffer called BAPTA that has low affinity for pH and has responds very rapidly to calcium. In the same vein, Roger is responsible for the concept of calcium imaging, the conceptualization of synthesis of photoreleasable ion chelators, the molecular understandings and design of genetically encodable fluorescent proteins, for which he got the Nobel Prize in 2008, the design and synthesis of tools to measure kinetic properties of enzymatic reactions through the use of fluorescent resonance energy transfer, et cetera, et cetera. The list of contributions are enormous, and they are too impressive to be summarized in a short time. As expected, the list of honors and awards that Roger Tsien has received are also way too long, and that I'm not going to do. I'm going to list the amount because it's going to take for a long time to do it. Needless to say, he got the Nobel Prize in 2008, and he is a fellow of almost every scientific academy that you can think of in the world. In an honorary degree. But Roger Tsien is not the type of investigator that rests on his laurels. Instead, he's using as a personal motivation the loss of his father due to pancreatic cancer. He has now engaged in a conceptualization, design, and synthesis of practical molecular tools to help in the war against cancer. In this respect, and before hearing from him, some of these things, I would like you to consider the following. It is very likely, almost certain, that everyone in this audience will personally benefit in the future from the oncoming investigations from Roger Tsien. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Roger Tsien to deliver the 2010 UCLA Physiology Distinguished Lecture entitled Breeding and Building Molecules to Spy on Cells and Tumors. Thank you.